Next to the Alliance boss, there is also now the Wildling event. The Wildling Siege, that is. Let's have a look. The Wildling Siege takes place every 14 days, with a maximum of 2 attempts that you can do in a row, and each time you do it, it will cost you 1 time. Now, people who attend this event have to be in alliance for at least 15 days, and they have to be on the same kingdom. So, this kind of excludes those that are, say, merit hunting on other kingdoms, or that do rebel trains lots of times. Now, what can you win with the Wildling Siege? Well, there are so-called personal point rewards. This is when you receive a specific number of points, and there are several difficulties. They go all the way up from here, from the easy until the hell. And also you can see that the rewards that you can win are better at a higher difficulty, which makes totally sense. And for instance, hell, you can see you can get here quite decent rewards. So to get to these rewards, you need to pass previous levels. If you have 25 people who make a good defense, you can go to 1 difficulty level higher. If you have 50, you can go for 2 higher. Now, during a Wildling Siege, you can also score individual points. You can do this by simply defeating the troops, and the more difficult troops there are, the more points you will get, but also by helping defending other people. This can give you already nice commanders for elite, so this is specifically nice for those who are still in the event of, let's say, who are still in the challenge, let's call it like that, to level these ones up. And as you can see here, the top 10 will get these rewards. Now, how should you prepare for a Wildling event? Well, basically, it's defending your castle, which means that your castle will need to have the best skin for your defense. Say, in my case, I'm infantry, so in this case, my castle exterior has to be the best that I'll use for infantry, which is, in my case, the Dornish tree. Same will go for the marching skin, which in my case is the Wandering Song. Then more is to be done. You can go to your regular city overview. Might take a few seconds. When you are at the city overview, you just make sure that you have your lord the way it should be. In my case, I'm going for Layla Mormont. Make sure also that your talons are set correctly. In my case, it would be my spear set up. There you go. Also make sure that you have your best outfit, which is, in my case, my infantry. You can also add some military preparations, like total attack, total defense. And of course, last but not least, you have to make sure that your refinement is set correctly. In my case, army and infantry attack. Now, this is basically all that you have to do. And even if you're not there, it's fine. You also have to make sure that your wall defense is good. In this case, you go to the wall and you check how your wall defense looks like. If it's okay the way you like it, you keep it like that. If you don't, you can make some changes. Also make sure that you have your counter set up correctly. And keep in mind that with this event, the troops that are being sent to your castle are always the formation of Inf Calf. So if you're Calf, that's best. During the event itself, X number of waves are being sent to all castles. The more waves you defeat, the more troops of these waves that you kill, the more points that you get. You will also get points for helping out other people's defense. And not surprisingly, each wave is stronger than the previous one. Bigger army size, bigger troops. That is basically it. And if you make it all the way till the end, you get all the rewards. And the best thing at all is that this event can run while you're away, as long as everything is set up correctly. Troops that are wounded will be healed for free. Same goes for the wall. It's being rebuilt for free. So overall, this is a very nice event, and it's totally for free, as long as you are 15 days in the Alliance and are located on the same kingdom.